Hello students, how are you? Hope all of you are doing well and maintaining good health. I am Dr. Smriti Rekha and I welcome you all to eTuition, Education for Better Tomorrow. It's a digital learning platform for Odia and English medium students which is developed in Odisha. If you believe in quality education, then you are in the right platform. So what are you waiting for? Please download the app and enroll yourself so that you will avail all the facilities at your fingertips. As in eTuition, we believe in quality education, which will definitely help you to build your career. So, students, without wasting much time, let us start today's class. As you can see, today we are going to solve exercise 2.3. As in the previous class, we have discussed the division algorithm. So exercise 2.3 related to division of polynomial. Hope you have watched all the videos related to polynomial. If you have not done, please watch all of them so that your concept will be clear. And to make it easy for you, I have given the link of the entire playlist of the videos related to class 10 in the description section. So let us start the class then. Are you all ready? Okay. So here comes your exercise 2.3. So the first question is, divide the polynomial px by the polynomial gx and find the quotient and the remainder in each of the following. So there are three bits. So I will do two for you and one is homework for you. So I think I will be doing bit one and bit two, and this is your homework. Okay children. So now what is your first question? So in your first question, px is equal to x cube minus 3x square plus 5x minus 3. So your dividend is x cube minus 3x square plus 5x. And your divisor is x square minus 2. Correct or not? So, your dividend is px, that is x cube minus 3x square plus 5x minus 3. And divisor is x square minus 2. So, we are going to use the normal long division method. If you remember how you are going to divide it. So, you have to divide the degree of the divisor. So the highest degree of the divisor with that of the highest degree of the dividend. So in this case, it is x cube. So x cube divided by x square initially you have to do. Then accordingly, you will get your quotient value. So how your division will be? So basically, you will get like this. So let us analyze. So as I was telling you, how you will get this x? So you will get this x like, so you have to divide x cube divided by x square. What is the answer? X. So that x you have written here. Now what about this value where you have got this x cube minus 2x? That is very simple. As you have put x in the quotient part, so you have to multiply that x with x square minus 2. So what is the value of x into x square minus 2? It is nothing but equal to x cube minus 2x. Correct or not? So now this x cube minus 2x has to be subtracted from the dividend. And subtraction will happen from the like terms. So that is the reason why here x cube has been written under x cube and minus 2x is written below 5x. Correct children? So now we have done the subtraction and your new dividend is minus 3x square plus 7x minus 3. Correct? So now what about the next part of the question? So as usual, like in the previous part, what you have done? So here also you are going to do the same. So minus 3x square divided by x square. What is the answer? It is minus 3. What is written here? It is minus 3. So x minus 3. So now what is your duty. What is your work to do? What has to be done? So this 3 has to be multiplied, minus 3 has to be multiplied with x square minus 2. If you multiply this minus 3 with x square minus 2, you will get minus 3x square minus 2 into minus 3. What's the answer? Plus 6. So that is what it is written here, right? So you have to subtract it. And finally, you are getting 7x minus 9. Can you go further? You cannot go further. Why you cannot go further? Because you have got the remainder whose degree is less than your divisor. So you have to proceed the division method unless and until you get the remainder equal to 0 or remainder value having degree less than the divisor. Correct, children? So we have to stop here. Then what is your quotient value and what is your remainder? So this is your quotient, right? So this is your quotient and this is your remainder. Correct or not? This is your remainder. So that is what it is written. So quotient is equal to x minus 3 and remainder is equal to 7x minus 9. Correct, children? You understood it? Okay. So now let us go to the next problem. So your next problem is px is equal to x to the power 4 minus 3x square plus 4x plus 5 and gx equal to x square plus 1 minus x. So you are going to divide it like in the previous problem how we have done. So what is dividend here? Dividend is equal to x to the power 4 minus 3x square plus 4x plus 5. And what is divisor here? X square plus 1 minus 6. Correct or not? So now we are going to divide it. So like in your previous method, what you have done? So you have to divide the highest degree of the dividend to that of the highest degree of the divisor. What is highest degree here? X to the power 4 divided by x square. What is the answer? X square. What is written here? X square. Now this x square has to be multiplied with the divisor. So we have multiplied x square into x square, x to the power 4. Then x square into minus 6. What is the value? It is minus 6 into x square. What is the value? Minus x cube plus 1 into x square. What is the value? It is x square. So you have to subtract from the like term. So we have subtracted x to the power 4 minus x to the power 4 and we have written x square below 3x square because it is like term and there was no x cube. So you have just written x cube. You have taken it to the outside. Okay, because there was no x cube term in your dividend. Correct or not? Now, let us subtract it. By subtracting, you will get, so this x cube will come here because it is the highest degree. We have to arrange in the standard form. So this x cube will come here. So x cube minus 3 minus 3x square minus x square. What is the answer? Minus 4x square plus 4x plus 5. Correct or not? So again, what you will do? X cube divided by x square. What is the answer? It is x. So what is written here? Plus x. Now we are going to multiply with this. So what is the answer? X cube minus x square plus x. Subtracting, you will get minus 3x square plus 3x plus 5. So this is your new dividend. Again following the same method, what you are going to do? Minus 3x square divided by x square. What is the answer? Minus 3. So that is written here. Now this minus 3 has to be multiplied with your divisor. So you will get minus 3x square plus 3x minus 3. Now you subtract it and what you are getting? You are getting it is equal to 8. Can you go further? Even if remainder is equal to 0, you cannot go further because the remainder degree is less than the degree of your divisor. So here you have to stop the division. So what is your quotient then? Quotient is equal to x square plus x minus 3. And what is your remainder? Remainder is equal to 8. Correct or not? So your quotient is equal to x square plus x minus 3 and remainder is equal to 8. Correct, children? Now, as I have already told you, page 3 is homework for you. So, do practice. Okay? Okay. Next question. Check whether the first polynomial is a factor of the second polynomial by dividing the second polynomial by the first polynomial. So, we have 3 bits. So, I will be doing 2 bits and the last one is your homework. Correct, children? So, shall we start the first bit then? So, in the first bit, as you can see, there are 2 polynomials. One is your t square minus 3. And the another one is, the second polynomial is 2t to the power 4 plus 3t cube minus 2t square minus 9t plus 12. Correct or not? So, you have to divide it. So if you divide, so it will be like this. So initially to get the quotient, you have to divide 2 to the t to the power 4 divided by t square, and you will be getting 2t square. So here it is written 2t square, and it is multiplied with t square minus 3, you will get 2t to the power 4 minus 6t square. So after subtracting, you will get your new dividend, that is 3t cube plus 4t square minus 9t minus 12. Again you are going to divide 3t cube divided by t square, that is equal to 3t. So here plus 3t. So now you multiply this plus 3t with t square minus 3, you will get minus 3t cube minus 9t. Correct or not? Now subtracting, you will get a new dividend, that is 4t square minus 12. And you divide it, 4t square divided by t square, and your answer is 4. You multiply this 4, you will be getting 4t square minus 12. That is equal to 0. So, this is your remainder, that is 0. If the remainder is 0, then definitely your t square minus 3 is a factor of the second polynomial. Correct or not? Okay. So, you have verified it. So, we can see as the remainder is 0, therefore t square minus 3 is the factor of 2t square plus 3t plus 4. Correct or not? So, now let us go to the second bit. That is x square plus, so first polynomial is x square plus 3x plus 1. And the second polynomial is 3x to the power 4 plus 5x cube minus 7x square plus 2x plus 2. Correct? So, this is your first polynomial and this is your second polynomial. So, when you will divide, you will get like this. So, you have 3x to the power 4. So, 3x to the power 4 divided by x square. What you are getting? 3x square. What is written here? 3x square. This has to be multiplied. You will get 3x to the power 4 plus 9x cube plus 3x square. Subtract it, you will get the new dividend. Okay. So, now in the new dividend, what is the highest degree? Minus 4x cube divided by x square. What is the answer? Minus 4x. What is written here? Minus 4x. So, this minus 4x will be multiplied with this. So, you will get minus 4x cube minus 12x square minus 4x. Subtract it, you will get the new dividend. What is the highest degree? 2x square divided by x square. How much you will get? 2. So, here plus 2 is written. You multiply it. And you will be getting remainder is equal to. If you are getting remainder is equal to 0, what do you mean by that? That means the first polynomial is the factor of the second polynomial. Correct or not? Understood, children? Okay. So, now let us go to the next problem. That is question number 3. Obtain all the zeros of 3x to the power 4 plus 6x cube minus 2x square minus 10x minus 5. If two of its zeros are root 5 by 3 and root minus root 5 by 3. So, that means if the degree is to the power 4, that means degree is 4, that means you will be having 4 roots for the equation, out of which 2 has been given to you. So, if you remember, if two zeros will be root 5 by 3 and minus root 5 by 3, then x plus root 5 by 3 and x minus root 5 by 3 is the factor of the polynomial. If you remember, this type of problem we have solved in the previous exercise also. Correct or not? Okay, so you will start from that. You will start from that factor that you consider as your polynomial, and that is polynomial, and you can take it as the divisor, and this polynomial with degree 4 as your second polynomial or dividend, then divide it, and taking the new quotient, you will get the next roots. Correct or not? This type of problem already we have solved in the previous exercise. Okay. So since this is a polynomial of degree 4, hence there will be total 4 roots. So as I was telling you, root 5 by 3 and minus root 5 by 3 are the zeros of the polynomial. So that means the product of x minus root 5 by 3 into x plus root 5 by 3 is also the factor of your the bigger polynomial, or the 3x to the power 4 plus 6x cube minus 2x square minus 10x minus 5. Correct or not? So it's a factor. So that means 3x square minus 5 is equal to 0. So this you have to divide with your second polynomial. So by dividing it, as usual, how you are going to do the divisor, you are going to follow the same methodology. So divide by 3x square, you will get x square. What is written here? X square you have to multiply here, you will get 3x to the power 4 minus 5 square. Subtract it, you will get the new dividend. Again you divide, 6x cube divided by 3x square, and you will get 3x, right? 2x. So this 2x you will write it here, then you multiply with this and subtract, you will get a new dividend. Now you divide 3x square by 3x square, you will get 1. Here 1 is written. Then you are going to multiply it. 3x square minus 5, what's the remainder? Remainder is equal to 0. That means your x square plus 2x plus 1 is also a factor of your polynomial. So your new polynomial is nothing but the product of x square plus 2x plus 1 into 3x square minus 5. So can we just split this particular equation by splitting the middle term and find out the factor, as we have done in the previous exercise also? So by doing so, you will get the other roots which is required in the question. Okay, so as I was telling you, first the polynomial is nothing but the product of your divisor and the quotient. So this is what you had got in the division, right? So now what I was telling you, you have to split the middle term. So here we have split the middle term in such a way that the multiplication is equal to 1 and addition is equal to 2. So 1 into 1. Multiplication, product, what is the answer? 1. 1 plus 1, what is the answer? It is 2. So now, can you factorize it? So by factorizing it, you will get 3x square minus 5 into x plus 1 into x plus 1. So what about the other zeros then? So the other zeros are, so you have x plus 1 is equal to 0, and also x plus 1 is equal to 0. Here also you can see x plus 1 whole square, right? So x plus 1 is equal to 0 and x plus 1 is equal to 0. So what are the other root then? It is minus 1 and minus 1. Correct or not? So that is what it is written here. Okay children, now shall we go to the next problem then? So your next problem is question number 4. On dividing x cube minus 3x square plus x plus 2 by polynomial gx, the quotient and the remainder were x minus 2 and minus 2x plus 4 respectively. Find gx. So here your quotient and remainder is given and divisor is not given. So you remember the formula? that is dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. This holds good for the polynomial also. So how you are going to find out this divisor? So dividend minus your remainder divided by quotient. That's all. Correct or not? So same thing we are going to follow here. So px is equal to x cube minus 3x x square plus x plus 2. Correct. So how you have to find out gx. Quotient is x minus 2. Remainder is minus 2x plus 4. On dividing px by gx, we have the quotient is equal to x minus 2 and minus 2x plus 4. So for how to approach for that? Like I told, so first you are going to subtract the remainder, then you will get a new polynomial divided by your quotient, you will get the answer. So you have, so by subtracting, as you can see, by subtracting the remainder, so initially your dividend was x cube minus 3x square plus x plus 2. What was your remainder? It is minus 2x plus 4. So remainder will go to that side. So minus 2x plus 4, that becomes plus 2x minus 4. So what is your new remainder? X cube minus 3x square 2x plus 2x is equal to plus 3x minus 2. Correct. So this is your dividend minus remainder. So divided by what you are going to divide? Quotient is how much? Quotient is x minus 2. Correct or not? So that is what it is written here. So divided by x minus 2, you have to find out. So here we have done the division. As usual, x cube divided by x, you will get x square. Multiply this x square with this, you will get this. Then you will get the new dividend like this, minus x square. Divide minus x square divided by x, you will get minus x. So you have written minus x here, multiply with x minus 2. Then you write it here, subtract it, you will get x minus 2. Then divide x divided by x, that is 1. So you have written plus 1 here. So x minus 2 into plus 1 is what? X minus 2. So dividend minus whatever you have got, x minus 2, that is equal to 0. So your remainder is 0 now. So what is your gx value? So gx is equal to x square minus x plus 1. X square minus x plus 1. Correct or not? Okay. So now let us go to the next problem. Give examples of polynomials ps, gx, qx and rx which satisfy the division algorithm, that is degree of px is equal to degree of qx. Okay. So let us take the first case. So according to the division algorithm, let us understand, dividend and divisor are two polynomials where gx is not equal to 0. Then we can find the value of quotient and remainder with a normal formula of division, that is dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder, where rx is equal to, remember, remainder can be 0 or the remainder degree is less than the degree of your divisor. Correct or not? Now let us prove the three given cases, which is the first one, degree of px is equal to degree of qx. So degree of dividend is equal to degree of quotient only when the divisor is constant term. Correct or not? So let us take one example. Suppose your px is equal to 3x square plus 3x plus 3. So here what is the degree of your polynomial? It is 2. And the degree of your qx. Qx means your quotient, right? Your quotient degree should be the same one. So this is possible because you have to divide the divisor. So if you are dividing the divisor, then your quotient will be, and divisor is having some degree, then definitely the quotient value is going to be less than, the degree of the quotient is going to be less than that. So It has to be equal. Then in that case, the degree of your divisor should be less than that of your it should be a constant. It should be a constant. Then only in that case, your degree of the quotient will be the same. Otherwise, it is not possible. Correct or not? So as you can see, if you divide it, you will get x square plus x plus 1, and it is having the same degree as that of the dividend. Correct or not? Okay, so by taking one example, you have to prove it. Okay, children. Now, so thus we can see the degree of cosine is equal to 2, which is equal to the degree of the dividend. Correct or not? So now, so the division algorithm is satisfied here. Now let us go to the second case. What is second case? When the degree of the cosine is equal to degree of the remainder. So for this, another example we have taken. So let us take an example. Px is equal to x square plus 3, and the dividend, the polynomial to be divided or the divisor is equal to x minus 1. So now let us divide it. So if you divide it, x square plus 3 is equal to x minus 1 into x. Can you write it in this form? So x minus 1, if you are confused, you can just go for the long division method and you will get the corresponding remainder. Also, if you want me to do it, I'll do it here. So x square plus 3, you divide it, you have x minus 1. So here you can write x. So if you write x there, here you will get x square and minus x. So what is the answer? So that is equal to, so it is x square, it is 0. So you will get here plus, so you will get x plus 3. So here x plus 3 is your remainder and x is the quotient. So what is written here? It is dividend is equal to divisor into quotient, which is nothing but equal to x plus the remainder. Correct or not? So that is what is written here. So here the quotient, what is quotient? It is x. Remainder, what is remainder? X plus 3. What is degree of remainder on the quotient? It is same. Correct or not? So the divisor algorithm is satisfied. Correct or not? Okay, so now let us take the third example or third case where the degree of the remainder is equal to 0. So when the degree of the remainder is equal to 0, when it is a constant. Correct or not? So a constant has degree is equal to 0. So the degree of the remainder is 0 only when the remainder left after division algorithm is a constant. So there is no ambiguity at all. So let us take one example. Suppose px is equal to x square plus 1 and the divisor is equal to x. So if you are going to divide it, so let us divide it for your convenience. Let me write x square plus 1. You are dividing by x. So here it will be x. So you can write x square here. Right. So what you are getting? It is x square plus 1. So what you are getting? You are getting how much? You are getting plus 1. Correct or not? So plus 1 is your remainder. What is degree of plus 1? It is 0, right? And the remainder rx is equal to 1. So what is degree of 1 here? Degree is 0, right? So your division algorithm is proved. Hence, the degree of the remainder is equal to 0. Correct or not? So by taking example, we have proved all the three cases. Okay, children, have you understood all the problems which I have solved? So don't forget to solve the problems which I have given you as homework. If you have any doubt, please ask me in the comment section. I will definitely get back to you. Thank you for your patient hearing, and keep smiling, and do follow us in YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. And don't forget to download the eTuition app and please enroll yourself. Okay, children, bye. Take care.